Hey, what's up, everybody? I'm going to do a complimentary quad, man. This quad is featuring the music of Cat Stevens. And we're going to do these four in succession, man, starting with Where Do the Children Play? Oh, Very Young, Lady D.R. Banville, and Father and Son. I know that Cat Stevens is a household name. I know I can think of maybe three, maybe even four songs that he's done off the top of my head. But I've never really had the opportunity, of course, to get into anything beyond his, I guess it would be well-known hits. Anyways, man. I'm looking forward to getting to know the man a little bit better. I just want to give a shout out first and a thanks very much to Zupiter. Zupiter, thank you very much, man. I appreciate this. Thank you for your patience. You're one of those patrons that got lost in the cracks, man, when I did some stupid shit and I erased a lot of my reactions calendar. And I know that your quad would have been done a lot sooner, so thanks for your patience. Thanks for not pestering the hell out of me. Some patrons have just been just impossible, man. And so thank you very much, you being one of them who have been very, very patient and understanding. So I appreciate that the most. Anyway, brother, thank you. Now, I'm pretty sure it's Zupiter the way you pronounce this, man. Zeupater, Zupiter. If it's Zupater or whatever it is, correct me, but I'm gonna address you as Zupiter. Alright, man. So let's start with our first track, man. Where Do the Children Play? Alright. Where Do the Children Play? Cat Stevens. Sorry, I just lost my damn link. Okay, there we go. All right. Where Do the Children Play? Let's get it.
Jumbo planes, taking a ride on a cosmic train. Switch on summer from a slot machine. Just get what you want to if you want, as you can get anything. I know we've come a long way. We're changing day to day, but tell me, where do the children play? Well, you roll on roads over fresh green grass for your lorry loads. And petrol gas, and you make them long, and you make them tough, but they just go on, and it seems that you can't get off. Oh, I know we've come a long way, we're changing day to day. But tell me, where do the children play?
sky. Scrapers fill the air. But will you keep on building higher till there's no more room up there? Will you make us laugh? Will you make us cry? Will you tell us when to live? Will you tell us when to die? I know we've come a long way. We're changing day to day. But tell me, where do the children play?
Brother's going deep with that one. Very, very straightforward. Straightforward is the words used to describe this song. You don't have to wonder what the hell he's talking about at all. You know, he lays it out and he gives it to you straight. Hey, this is where we're heading. This is what I'm seeing going on right now. And there has to be some sort of a change in balance, or else it's going to end up like this. It's going to end up being sad like this, to the point now where our damn children can't even play anywhere safe. There's nowhere left. Our industrialized age is just pushing against so many things. It's good in one aspect, but I think it's the overindulgence factor that's really choking us out. It's the population density that's choking us out. So we've got some colossal global issues that we've got to really, really look at and come up with a solution for. He's also, without saying it, calling for a unification of world government, because it's on that level that it's going to affect the changes that he's singing about. This is some deep shit, I'm telling you. That's why I was sitting there all stunned and I couldn't really say anything. Usually I have thoughts come to me and I just say things, but when you see that I'm not saying a word, that means that I'm deep in it. Okay, man. Cat Stevens. What a singing voice, too. I didn't sleep on his singing voice. I didn't sleep on the mastery of his musicianship. As simple as it is, it's still very, very intricate, and it really helps to set the mood and the platform of whatever it is that he wants to sing about. So he is definitely a great musician, and also, of course, very, very talented natural singer. As soon as I say talented natural singer, I am thinking about someone in the likes of Elton John. I don't know how much work Elton, for example, put into his development as a singer, but he strikes me as somebody it just came to naturally. Cat Stevens strikes me as that kind of person. When I think of Cat Stevens, I also think of Jim Croce. It's as if maybe they were, I don't know, roommates at one point in time. And they kind of influenced each other. And of course, they went in slightly different paths. But it seems that they have this complemental element that at some point in time, maybe in a different life, they could be brothers. You know what I'm saying? Maybe you don't know what I'm saying. It's just my thoughts. Let me know if I have any basis for that sentiment. I feel that way and I don't know why. But let me know. Set me straight. I'm sure somebody will. When I'm way off, there is just definitely no lack in people getting up in my face. So, all right. Let me do a little background here, man. Very, very interesting man. I know that he's also a Muslim, and he's been a Muslim for I don't know how long, but that I do know about him. All right, so actually, Let me read a little note here from Jupiter, and then we'll go and check out where did the children play. So Jupiter says, quote, Peace Train and Wild World are great songs, but too obvious for me, so I didn't include them here. Maybe for a future quad. I hope you enjoy this set, though. I don't know if you're familiar with Cat Stevens' story. He goes by Yusuf Islam now, or Yusuf/Cat Stevens in song credits. Hope you enjoy. Peace. Thanks, Jupiter. Appreciate it, man. I've been enjoying it so far. First song. Excellent song in so many ways. Yeah, okay, so Wikipedia, here we are. Where Did the Children Play? Where Did the Children Play is a song by British folk rock musician Cat Stevens, opening his November 1970 album, Tea for the Tillerman. The song reflects awareness of the turmoil of the late 60s and the issues involved: war, urban sprawl, poverty, ecological disaster, and the future of humankind. The same themes and concerns are repeated later in many of his songs. The song was among several of Stevens' songs that were used for the soundtrack of the 1971 movie Harold and Maude. The film features the song during a scene where lead character Harold is driving past a military graveyard, panning out to show a vast number of little tiny white graves, thus underscoring the point of the song. In 2005, Stevens/Islam re-recorded the selection as a duet with Dolly Parton on her album, Those Were the Days. In 2017, Garbage recorded a cover of the song for United Nations charity album, Music to Inspire, Artists United Against Human Trafficking. Wow. Yeah, this song, man, it's timeless in a way. You know, you can apply a lot of those sentiments from the 60s to now. And some of the big, big things still hold strong. War, urban sprawl, poverty, ecological disasters, the future of mankind. All of those things apply to the now. Yes, we're technology has advanced and brought us a higher standard of living for a big part of the free world. But there are still lots of issues, ecological disasters, urban sprawl, poverty, lots of different things that could really threaten not only our way of life in the Western world, but all around the world, and also ultimately leading to some serious problems down the road, a collapse on many different levels, man. So yeah, this song is timeless. And it applies to today as much as it did in the 60s, for sure. All right. So, man, let's bounce to our second track here. And that being Oh Very Young. All right. Cat Stevens, Oh Very Young. Let's get it.
Oh, very young, what will you leave us this time? You're only dancing on this earth for a short while. And though your dreams may toss and turn you now, they will vanish away like your dad's best jeans, denim blue, fading up to the sky. And though you want them to last forever, you know he never will. You know he never will. And the patches make the goodbye harder still. Oh, very young, what will you leave us this time? There'll never be a better chance to change your mind. And if you want this world to see better days, will you carry the words of love with you? Will you ride the great white bird into heaven? And though you want to last forever, you know you never will. You know you never will. journey harder still.
I remember this tune, man. Holy cow. I can't begin to tell you how long it's been since I've heard it. And when you say Cat Stevens to me, of course I'm thinking of Peace Train, Wild World. And if you force me, I'll come up with a few more. But Oh Very Young would not be in that lineup of songs that I would just pull out of the air. It's one of those great forgotten gems, obviously. Great song, holy cow. Strong message. In a way, I guess the lyrics are reminding us to always go back to a time of youthful innocence when things were simpler. In a way, it's saying not to take life too seriously. Focus on the big picture of what's really, really important. Grab the moment, live in the now, and not get so caught up being adults in the sense of always on the go, always having something. There's a lot of strife going on, you know, either at our in our professional lives, at our workplace, things of that nature. So all of those things are not in the concern of a young person. When I'm thinking of a young person, I'm thinking of someone who's probably maybe preteen or in their teens and don't have really a lot of care in the world at the moment. You know what I mean? That moment of innocence when you're just existing to just live and take it all in and you're enjoying the moment. You know, I guess there's a point when we break away from that and reality kicks in with life and all that sort of thing. But it's nice to be able to reconnect, I guess, to the past and to those memories and that state of being when we were carefree and didn't have too many worries. I think so. Maybe I'm missing something else. Let me know if I'm missing something else out of this song. Great tune. Great harmony. Nice singing voice in the backup singer there. Nice voice on that lady. Great tune. Yo, man, this guy, man, his singing voice. Could you imagine being able to sing like that? Unbelievable. What an... I don't know. What a natural talent. That's what I was just about to say. If you know your Cat Stevens history, tell me. I mean, you know, there's probably a certain degree of developing your singing voice, your singing style, your that sort of thing. But these guys coming back from the early 60s and whatnot, probably more of them didn't have any kind of formative schooling in music and developing their voice and all of that sort of thing. So that's why I'm thinking that he's probably more naturally trained. Let me know if I'm wrong, though. Let me know if I'm wrong about Elton John. I've always carried that assumption. Maybe I'm totally wrong. All right. So, Oh Very Young. Oh Very Young is a song composed by Cat Stevens. It was released on his 74 album Buddha and The Chocolate Box, as well as several later Best Of and Greatest Hits albums. This song that poses a question asked by future generations reached number 10 on the US Billboard Hot 100 and number 2 on the Easy Listening. On his website, djallyn.org, djallyn.org, DJ Ali posted the following about O Very Young on April 30th, 2009. And I quote, "Its lyric is a gentle response to Don McLean's hit American Pie, released 2 years previously. Like McLean, he stops short of mentioning Buddy Holly directly, but questions the ill-fated songwriter's Not Fade Away, the last song Holly performed. Lyric, a love to last more than one day, a lover's love, not faded away, with Stephen's own denim blue fading up to the sky. And though you want him to last forever, you know he never will, and the patches make the goodbye harder still." Stevens then mentions the young American's mold-breaking work, Words of Love, in the line, "Will you carry the words of love with you? Will you ride the great white bird into heaven? And though you want to last forever, you know you never will, and the goodbye makes the journey harder still." Unquote. Susan Lynch worked as a session musician until she became a regular part of Cat Stevens' group, vocal group, and appeared on several of his albums. The first song Lynch did for Stevens was O Very Young, in which she sang the solo line and a haunting background melody. It's a nice way to describe it. Jonathan Rayson also covered the song on his 2006 album, Shiny and New. All right. So that is Wikipedia Song Fact Info on O Very Young. Great tune, man. Great tune. Inspired to a certain degree by Buddy Holly. Buddy Holly, man. Yeah. I gotta do something with Buddy Holly. In a year, over a year now, I've been doing this. I haven't even touched a Buddy Holly song. I haven't even come close. I gotta do something with Buddy Holly. Yeah, send me some links and some material to do something with Buddy Holly, man. Yeah, I gotta do something with that great musician. Taken from us too soon. He would definitely be a great candidate for the Gone Too Soon series. I think that's what I'll do. I'll pencil him in for a Gone Too Soon. Send me some Buddy Holly stuff, will you? All right. Lady D.R. Bonneville. That's our next track, man. Lady D.R. Bonneville. Let's get it.
My lady D'Arbonville,
D'Arbonville,
why do you sleep so still? I'll wake you tomorrow, and you will be my fill. Yes, you will be my fill. My lady D'Arbonville, does it grieve me so? But your heart seems so silent. Why do you breathe so low? Why do you breathe so low? My lady D'Arbonville, why do you sleep so still? I'll wake you tomorrow, and you will be my fill. Yes, you will be my fill. My lady D'Arbonville, you look so cold tonight. Your lips feel like winter. Your skin has turned to white. Your skin has turned to white. My lady da Bonville, why do you sleep so still? I'll wake you tomorrow, and you will be my fill. Yes, you will be my fill. La 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 la. 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 My lady da Bonville, why do you greet me so? But your heart seems so silent. Why do you breathe so low? Why do you breathe so low? I loved you, my lady. Though in your grave you lie, I'll always be with you. This rose will never die. This rose will never die. I loved you, my lady. Though in your grave you lie, I'll always be with you. This rose will never die. This rose will never die.
That was masterful. I don't throw around masterful too often, man. That was masterful, masterfully crafted. Metaphorically singing about putting someone to rest. He's not singing about someone who's passed on. He's singing about a relationship that has faded, that has died, that has lost the, maybe not the love, but the passion, the connection. I guess two people may be going their separate ways, or he's finally realizing that it's not meant to be, and he's got to go a different way or let go of it, something like that. But he's putting the relationship to rest finally. He's letting go. He's learning to let go. Maybe he was holding on too tight. Yeah, man. Great, holy, fantastic piece of work there. Slow down to give you some context, and then it's sped up a little bit in the chorus to give you a mood. Yo, man. That's great craftsmanship. Great musical craftsmanship. Wow. Lady da Bonville. I was pronouncing it wrong. Please don't slay me. Apologies ahead of time for my bad reading. Lady da Bonville. Alright, so Lady da Bonville is a song written and recorded by Cat Stevens and released in April of 1970. It subsequently appeared on his third album, Mona Bone Jacon, J-A-K-O-N, released later that year. It was his first single released after signing a contract with Island Records with the encouragement of his new producer, Paul Samuel Smith, fostering a folk rock direction. Lady da Bonville has a madrigal sound and was written about Stevens' former girlfriend, Patty da Bonville, metaphorically laying her to rest. Okay. Wow. Could you imagine being Patty da Bonville and hearing this for the first time and knowing that, he's finally kind of let go? I don't know what the state of the relationship was. Maybe he was just breaking it to her in song, And he was letting go first, and maybe she was still holding on. So that would be heartbreaking to hear it. Or maybe she moved on and then he left him. And so now he's finally decided to let it go. But either way, to hear this, being Patty Darbonville must have been really heart-wrenching. I'm just speculating. Lost my way here. Okay, yeah. Just at the completion of his second album with Hearst, Stevens contracted tuberculosis and a collapsed lung, requiring hospitalization and rest for a year. During this time, he spent his empty hours writing over 40 songs, and upon a clean bill of health, successfully negotiated out of his Durham contract and settled on Island Records' Paul Samuel Smith as his new producer, who encouraged Stevens' inclinations towards an emerging folk rock genre. And out of that came Crosby, Stills, Nash, and all of those great folk rock artists. As Stevens was nearing the end of his period of recuperation, he attended a party that boasted a gathering of musicians in London, including Jimmy Page, Steve Winwood, Ginger Baker, Eric Clapton, and others in attendance. It's funny, speaking of Jimmy Page, I was thinking immediately about the Yardbirds when they were separating. And as they're saying about this emerging folk rock genre, and as this folk rock genre was emerging, the Yardbirds were probably coming to an end. And half the Yardbirds wanted to enter into this folk rock genre. And Jimmy himself wanted to go into more of a heavier route where, you know, you were following the likes of Clapton and Cream and Hendrix, that sort of thing. So it's very, very interesting, the connecting threads in rock and roll. You know, they're all connected. And when you read about this sort of thing, you see those connecting lines, those connecting threads. You know, I'm seeing it anyway. I guess maybe because I'm seeking, and that's why I'm doing with this channel. But I love, I don't know, uncovering these little bits and pieces. And so here you go, the next sentence, Jimmy Page is in the next sentence. I don't know, little things like that gets me. All right, reading on. Among the party goers was Patty Darbonville, a U.S. teenager who was pursuing a modeling career at the time. She later gained prominence as an actress. The two began dating over a period of more than a year. Darbonville stayed with him whenever she was in London, but often found her career taking her to Paris and New York City. After over a year with her, Stevens was willing to invest more in a serious relationship than his young, ambitious girlfriend. It was on such a foray to New York that she heard his song about her on the airwaves. Her reaction was one of sadness. She said, quote, "I just have to be myself for a while, to do what I want to do. It's good to be alone sometimes. Look, Stevens' given name, wrote that song when I left for New York. I left for a month. It wasn't the end of the world, was it? But he wrote this whole song about Lady Darbonville, Why Do You Sleep So Still? It's about me dead. So while I was in New York, for him it was like I was lying in a coffin. He wrote that because he missed me, because he was down. It's a sad song." Darbonville continues, "I cried when I heard it, because that's when I knew it was over for good." Yeah. Sad state of affairs, man. But I imagine that that happens when you are, that happens often when you are a celebrity and you've got all kinds of obligations and you're jet setting everywhere, especially when you're on the rise and you're young and you really, really have to establish yourself and you're not writing your own ticket yet. You're still in the process of establishing yourself. So when the call comes, you just gotta go. You know what I mean? And you gotta do that for a good while until finally you've made it. And now you can kind of write your own ticket. You can put the brakes on and say, hey, okay, now we're not gonna tour as much because we're noteworthy, we're household names, we are the bosses of our own coming and going. So now we can put the brakes on a little bit and structure our life for ourselves and now commit to our relationship. You know, I mean, hey, it's sad that this had to happen that way, but I understand her position. Oftentimes, a lot of the times, I remember growing up as a young man, we were taught, especially the men in our church association and that sort of thing, you know, it doesn't matter if Mrs. Wright comes along, if you have not established yourself yet, if you have not fulfilled your financial goals, do not commit to a relationship until you've done so. Now, some people take offense to that. Some people are, no, we can work it together and we can do this and this and this. So there's different trains of thought in regards to that. And it's always a very, very debatable subject matter. But I understand why she had to do it the way she did. You know, I imagine these days it would be a lot easier with traveling being so much easier and things of that nature. But still, those challenges will exist. It's very interesting. And I'll leave it there. I don't want to open up a discussion and have a pissing contest in the comments section. So I'll leave it right there. All right, man. Great song. Fantastic song, man. Let's bounce to our last track. Father and Son. All right. Cat Stevens, Father and Son. Let's get it.
It's not time to make a change. Just relax, take it easy. You're still young, that's your fault. There's so much you have to know. Find a girl, settle down. If you want, you can marry. Look at me, I am old, but I'm happy. I was once like you are now, and I know that it's not easy to be calm when you found something going on. But take your time, think a lot. Why, think of everything you've got, for you will still be here tomorrow, but your dreams may not. How can I try to explain? When I do, he turns away again. It's always been the same, same old story. From the moment I could talk, I was ordered to listen. Now there's a way, and I know that I have to go away.
This is the Son.
I know I have to go.
Two different POVs.
Change, just sit down, take it slowly. You're still young, that's your fault. There's so much you have to go through. Find a girl, settle down. If you want, you can marry. Look at me, I am old, but I'm happy. All the times that I've cried, keeping all the things go.
Wow. Another powerful song. Setting up a very interesting dynamic that I'm betting you a number of fathers and sons go through. I'm thinking of a few different scenarios. I'm thinking of a father trying to keep his son from going away to war, joining a movement, a revolution, a peace force, things of that nature that has very, very, very dire consequences if things go bad, of course. Thinking of a scenario where the father has built an empire, a dynasty, and he wants his son to succeed him, and the son decides, no, I'm going to go in a different direction. And I mentioned Sunday school. I mentioned a church group when I was younger in my teens. I was attending a church group for men. You know, there are certain things women have to know being Christian women, certain things men have to know being Christian men, that sort of thing. And, you know, I was voluntold. I had no choice. Yeah, well, my parents were like, yo, you're living in this house, boy. You're going to go to church. You're going to go to Sunday school. I brought you into this world. I'll take your ass up. Go to church. So I had to go to church. But, you know, I mean, as I was sitting there and I was taking some of this in, I'm like, you know, 13, 14. I remember one of the elders. He was a really, really well-renowned elder. And he had a son. And everyone expected the son to grow up and, of course, take over the mantle from his father, succeed his father. And the son, at the last moment, I think he was 18, 19, he decided that he was going to go in a totally different direction. And he went off and joined the Air Force, became a fighter pilot. And I don't know, it's been, geez, how long has it been? Maybe 30 years since I last heard about it, but still to this day, the father has not spoken to the son. And, you know, I mean, the son has done some great things. I know he's a combat vet. I believe he joined the Brazilian Air Force, flying Mirage jets, and he's a decorated person, and he's helped to do a lot of humanitarian works in the jungles and all of these different things in South America. But still to this day, as I recall, this was many years ago, that the father has still not spoken to the son. So sometimes a subject matter like this in this song, when it applies to a real life situation, man, can really be very profound. And as this song is playing, that story came back to me. It started to come back to me in the middle of the song, and I started to think deeply about it. And wow. Yeah. And if I was to go back and try to recollect and catch up to some previous friends, Sunday school classmates, I bet you it's probably the very same. If the father's still around. Yeah, I don't know. But I bet you it's probably still the same. You know, still mad at the son for not taking over the mantle. So it can be a very, very serious subject matter. And obviously it probably caused a tremendous amount of strain, not just on the family, but the church congregation. They were kind of like a two diverging opinions, and some members of the family blamed a certain number of congregation people who were encouraging him. And so you can see that slippery slope of how it can turn very, very bad where it comes to relations and things of that nature. Very, very deep and serious subject matter. So yeah, man, this song just brought that back to me. All right, I went way the hell off there, man. This quad is going to be over an hour for sure. All right, man, let's do a little bit of read. Father and son. Father and son is a popular song written and performed by English singer-songwriter Cat Stevens, now known as Yusuf Islam, on his 1970 album Tea for the Tillerman. The song frames a heartbreaking exchange between a father not understanding a son's desire to break away and shape a new life, and the son who cannot really explain himself but knows that it's time for him to seek his own destiny. Origins. Cat Stevens originally wrote Father and Son as part of a proposed musical project starring Nigel Hawthorne called Revolutia, that was set during the Russian Revolution and could also have become a film. The song was about a boy who wanted to join the revolution against the wishes of his conservative farmer father. The musical project faded away when Stevens contracted TB in 69. He was close to death at the time of his admittance to the King Edward Hospital in Midhurst, West Sussex. After a year-long period of convalescence in the hospital and a collapsed lung, the project was shelved, but Father and Son remained, now in a broader context that reflected not just the societal conflict of Stevens' time, but also captured the impulses of older and younger generations in general. Yeah, it certainly does, man. Father and Son received substantial airplay on progressive rock and album-oriented rock radio formats, and played a key role in establishing Stevens as a new voice worthy of attention. Interviewed soon after the release of Father and Son, Stevens was asked if the song was autobiographical. Responding to the interviewer from Disc, he said, quote, "I've never really understood my father, but he always let me do whatever I wanted. He let me go. Father and Son is for those people who can't break loose." Unquote. Yeah, so many examples. I'm sure that if you think real hard yourself, you can probably come up with an example of that. Kind of like my story, yeah, an example of that. Something like that, probably even more profound. By 2007, Stevens, then known as Yusuf Islam, recorded the song again in Yusuf's Cafe Sessions of 2007 on DVD again with Alan Davies and a small band playing acoustic instruments. The performance was presented in a video with two close camera shots of his wife and daughter holding his infant grandchild. How reflective. All right, maybe his grandchild will grow up to be just like him, who's to say? Yo, man, wow. Zupiter, what a great quad, brother. Fantastic. These songs are really, really deep, man. They have a lot to say. This folk rock platform is very, very strong and influential, and it's a great, great utility used by Cat Stevens. And, you know, I mean, yeah, of course, the folk rock platform is used very well by a lot of artists, but definitely when you throw folk rock out there, I imagine that Cat Stevens would probably be one of those artists that you think of right away. I wasn't brought up on folk or rock or anything like that, and even I would pull Cat Stevens out of my hat. If you throw it at me, folk rock, give me a few artists, go. Cat Stevens would be one of those people, so I know that much, you know what I mean? Yeah, man, great platform for him to say what he needs to say, and say it so well. And I know that some of you are going to slay me for saying this. It really bugs some people when I say this. I'm going to say it, though. I believe that the classic rock platform, in its little different shifts, folk rock, whatever, jazz rock, I'm thinking of Steely Dan, of course, it allows the artist to say more. I think that the rock platform allows the artist to go deeper, say more. There are exceptions to the rule, like Bob Marley's Redemption Song, and Marvin Gaye's Mercy, Mercy Me, What's Going On, all of those things. But by and large, if you were to line up all of these songs that have a very strong, profound statement to make, classic rock is clearly the winner, in my opinion. It's an ignorant opinion because I don't have any real facts to go by, except that it's just a feeling, a perspective, an outlook, an impression based on what I've heard, what I've experienced growing up or whatever, especially now in the last year and a half of launching this channel. That's one of the big takeaways since I've started this channel that I hold dear, that classic rock allows someone to say a lot more. If you disagree with me, I'm going to hear about it because I hear about it often. If you agree with me, let me know. Because it's one of those things that I know that I should not venture, but sometimes I just, you know, have to. Some things I should not talk about, this is one of those things, but you know, I have to right now in regards to this reaction and Cat Stevens using this folk rock platform. It's just appropriate to mention it, and it's how I feel. So yes, do your worst and slay me if you will. So before I bounce, man, let me just go down, scroll down here and see what I got coming up. So Allman Brothers, I'm going to be hitting their fourth studio album, Allman Brothers and Sisters, it's called. I'll definitely jump on more complimentary quads while I still have my time off and I have the ability to do so. My goal is to catch up on the quads, man, and get those done. Yeah, speaking of the quads, who do I? I believe it's the Town People is up next. Nazareth, I believe it is. And I know I've got Akachita coming up. I want to do a back-to-back comparison between Tommy Bolin and Jeff Beck. I got that coming up. I got a Patreon exclusive coming up. And geez, I can't remember who it's for. Janis Joplin is coming up. So I got a couple of things for the complimentary quads and things of that nature coming up. But that's it for now, man. This is my reaction to this great quad. Zupruder, thank you very much. You outdid yourself. And apologies, too, for... I didn't deliberately say, well, I am not going to do reactions for Peace Train or Wild World. I said to Zupruder that I know of these. When you say Cat Stevens, what do you know of? This is what I know. So I don't think that Zupruder took it as a cue to not include them. I think that he was just saying of his own accord that, you know, those are great songs. Yeah, like his note says, those are great songs, but too obvious for me. And so he's speaking for himself. He's not speaking for me. So I think what he's really saying is that there's just so much more of Cat Stevens beyond his well-known hits, even by me, right? And so I have no problem with, you know, venturing into an area where maybe some of his stuff is not that well known, but still very, very good. I mean, fantastic, you know. So I think that's where we're going with that. But I'm not ruling out including Peace Train or Wild World in I don't know, a future reaction or a quad or anything of that sort. I know sometimes it's a double standard. What am I saying? Well, for example, I dare not, and I'll say it again, I dare not ever skip a Led Zeppelin song. You know, the only song from Led Zeppelin I've ever skipped was The Crunch, and mainly because I just don't like the song. And some people still will take jabs at me almost a 6 months later for not including that song. You know what I'm saying? Even though it's my opinion and it's my choice not to do a reaction to it because I just don't like it. The way I roll on my channel is I will not waste time posting reactions to songs that I don't like. There's enough songs out there in the classic rock element, and I'm only going to spend time on songs that I do like. If there's a song that I don't like, I'm just not going to post a reaction to it, man. The only time you'll see that is if, let's say, it's an album, full album format, and the song is kind of embedded in it, then I'll give you an impression and an overall of the album, not so much the song itself, you know what I mean? So there has been a few songs and a couple of full album reactions that I was not so crazy about. But because of the Led Zeppelin format where I'm going from song to song, I had to own up to it. And hey, to this day, I still stay firm in my position. I do not like the crunch, sorry. But still, man, I still get it from some people. So all of that to say that, yes, it is a double standard where, I have to do every single song. And like, for example, the popular Peace Train and Wild World, we might not ever do that because I'm so familiar with it. I remember when I did my Bob Seger quad, old time rock and roll was included, and it was a great division between subscribers. Oh man, we've heard this a million times, you don't have to waste time doing that. And then you'd have the other crowd that would say, yo, you cannot do a Bob Seger quad without including that. That is one of his signature songs. It's got to be in there. So there was a great division and a lot of back and forth in the comment section. So here I am in the middle. What do I do, right? So it's a bit of a double standard sometimes. Should I do the more popular ones or should I not? If I do the more popular ones, some people will get on me for it. If I don't include it, some people will get on me for it. So it's always sometimes a toss up in the end. Anyway, I'm just talking and rambling on, wasting more time here on this quad. Anyway, Zupiter, thanks, man. Thank you very much for this fantastic quad. If there's any more Cat Stevens stuff that you guys think that I should check out, please send it my way. He's a great artist, great songwriter, and his creativeness is steered and motivated by passion. And he's got a very, very great outlook on life, and it's passion that leads him to create. And and you can feel it. You can tell just by the way he puts things together, the way he expresses himself, the way he arranges things. Great, fantastic listens. All four of these songs, I love them all. All right, man, I'm done here. Thanks very much. Next time you see me, it'll probably be another complimentary quad. More than likely, that's the townspeople's quad. So that's that. And I'll probably do a Patreon exclusive as well coming up. So thanks for joining me, man. Have yourself a great Boxing Day. And I'll see you tomorrow. Peace.